Hello and welcome to Amazing Aircraft. The Comanche was a stealth-armed reconnaissance and attack helicopter designed for the U.S. Army in the 1980s and 1990s. It was supposed to be the ultimate scout and light fighter, able to sneak behind enemy lines, spot and destroy targets, and evade detection and fire. But it was canceled in 2004 after spending nearly $7 billion. In this video, we will explore the Comanche's design, technology, capabilities, development, and cancellation, and why it never became operational. So, are you ready to dive into its story? Then buckle up, and let's go. What if I told you that there was a helicopter that could fly faster, quieter, and stealthier than any other in the world? A helicopter that could sneak behind enemy lines, spot and destroy targets, and evade detection and fire? A helicopter that looked like something out of a sci-fi movie? Well, that helicopter was the Comanche, the most advanced and secretive helicopter program in history. But it was also the most expensive and controversial, and it was canceled before it ever entered service. The Comanche was a sleek and futuristic-looking helicopter with a streamlined fuselage, a five-blade main rotor, and a canted tail rotor. It was smaller and lighter than the AH-64 Apache attack helicopter that it was meant to accompany, and it could fit more easily onto transport ships or fly long distances on its own. The Comanche was powered by two LHTEC-T800 turboshaft engines, each producing up to 1,563 horsepower. It could carry a crew of two, a pilot and a co-pilot gunner, who sat in tandem in a narrow cockpit. But the Comanche's most distinctive feature was its stealth technology, which made it harder to detect by radar, infrared, acoustic, and visual sensors. The Comanche's exterior surfaces were faceted and covered with radar-absorbent material and infrared suppressant paint, reducing its radar cross-section to 360 times smaller than the Apache's. The Comanche's main and tail rotors were also designed to reduce noise and vibration, making it quieter than other helicopters of the same light class. The Comanche's chin-mounted 20mm three-barrel rotary cannon could be pointed rearwards and retracted under a fairing when not in use, further reducing its radar signature. The Comanche also had advanced avionics, including navigation and detection systems, that allowed it to operate at night and in bad weather. It had a digital fly-by-wire flight control system and a helmet-integrated display and sight system that projected information and images onto the crew's helmets. The benefits of the Comanche's stealth design were increased survivability and surprise. At the same time, the drawbacks were reduced payload and higher maintenance costs. The Comanche could evade enemy radar and missiles and perform covert missions and surprise attacks. It could also communicate and coordinate with other stealth platforms, such as the F-22 Raptor and the F-35 Lightning II. However, the Comanche also had to sacrifice some of its payload and performance to achieve its stealth. It could only carry a limited amount of weapons and sensors internally, and mounting them externally would compromise its stealth. It also had to deal with the weight and complexity of the stealth materials and systems, which increased its cost and maintenance requirements. The Comanche was estimated to cost $58 million per unit, and $1,000 per flight hour to maintain in 2000, according to the U.S. Government Accountability Office. The Comanche was not only a stealthy helicopter but also a smart one. It had advanced avionics and sensors that gave it a high level of situational awareness and combat effectiveness. One of the Comanche's key features was its digital fly-by-wire flight control system, which used computers and electronic signals to control the helicopter's movements. This system made the Comanche more agile and responsive, and also reduced the pilot's workload and fatigue. The system also allowed the Comanche to perform some autonomous functions, such as hovering, landing, and obstacle avoidance. Another important feature was the helmet-integrated display and sight system, or HIDSS, which was worn by both the pilot and the co-pilot gunner. The HIDSS projected information and images, such as flight data, maps, targets, and weapon status, onto the crew's helmets. The HIDSS also allowed the crew to aim and fire their weapons by simply looking at the target. The HIDSS was integrated with the Comanche's other sensors and systems, such as the Integrated Communications, Navigation, and Identification Avionics, or ICNIA, and the Target Acquisition and Designation System, or TADS. The ICNIA was a suite of radios, data links, and transponders that enabled the Comanche to communicate and coordinate with other aircraft and ground forces. The ICNIA also provided the Comanche with navigation and identification capabilities, such as GPS, IFF, and ADS-B. The ICNIA was designed to be secure, jam-resistant, and interoperable with other platforms. The TADS was a system of cameras, lasers, and radars that allowed the Comanche to detect and engage targets. The TADS included a mast-mounted sight, or MMS, which was a rotating sensor that could be raised above the rotor to scan the surroundings without exposing the helicopter. The MMS had a forward-looking infrared system, or FLIR, a laser rangefinder and designator, and a millimeter wave radar. The TADS also included a nose-mounted FLIR, which provided a wider field of view and a backup for the MMS. The TADS could operate at night and in adverse weather conditions, and could designate targets for the Comanche's weapons or the Apaches. The Comanche's avionics and sensors were impressive and innovative, but they also posed some challenges and risks. One of the challenges was the software development and integration, which was complex and time-consuming. The Comanche's software had to manage and coordinate multiple systems and functions, and to ensure their reliability and compatibility. The software also had to be tested and verified, which required extensive simulations and flight trials. Software development and integration were among the main causes of the Comanche's delays and cost overruns. Another challenge was cybersecurity and electronic warfare, which were becoming more prevalent and sophisticated. The Comanche's avionics and sensors relied on digital and wireless technologies, which made them vulnerable to cyberattacks and jamming. The Comanche's enemies could try to hack, spoof, or disrupt its communications, navigation, and identification systems or interfere with its target acquisition and designation systems. The Comanche had to protect its avionics and sensors from these threats and to be able to operate in a contested electromagnetic environment. The Comanche was not only a stealthy and smart helicopter, but also a deadly one. It had a variety of weapons and capabilities that made it a formidable opponent on the battlefield. The Comanche had a 20mm three-barrel rotary cannon, the AGM-114 air-to-ground missiles, the AIM-92 air-to-air missiles, and the optional external stub wings. The cannon could fire up to 1,500 rounds per minute and had a range of 2,500 meters. The Hellfire missiles could hit targets up to 8 kilometers away and had different warheads for different types of targets. The Stinger missiles could engage aerial targets up to 5 kilometers away and had infrared and ultraviolet seekers for better accuracy. The external stub wings could carry up to 8 Hellfire missiles or 16 Stinger missiles, but this would reduce the Comanche's stealth. The Comanche could engage targets with precision and flexibility and switch between stealth and attack modes. It could use its sensors and helmet display to locate and designate targets and fire its weapons by simply looking at them. It could also communicate and coordinate with other aircraft and ground forces and designate targets for the Apache. It could perform both reconnaissance and attack missions or switch between them as needed. It could also operate in different environments, such as urban, mountainous, or desert areas. The Comanche had a speed of 319 km per hour, a range of 2,222 km, an endurance of 2.5 hours, and a maneuverability of 180-degree turn in under 5 seconds. It compared favorably with other helicopters in terms of speed, range, and stealth, but unfavorably in terms of payload, cost, and maintenance. The Comanche was faster than the Kiowa and the Black Hawk and comparable to the Apache. It had a longer range than the Kiowa and the Apache, and was similar to the Black Hawk. It had a lower radar cross-section than any of them and a much lower acoustic signature. However, the Comanche could carry fewer weapons and sensors than the Apache, and had a higher unit cost and maintenance cost than any of them. The Comanche's armament and performance were impressive and versatile, but they also depended on many factors. One of the factors was the weather, which could affect the Comanche's visibility, stealth, and sensors. The Comanche could operate at night and in bad weather. Still, it could also be detected by thermal or optical sensors or by precipitation or dust. Another factor was the terrain, which could affect the Comanche's maneuverability, survivability, and target acquisition. The Comanche could fly low and fast, and use the terrain to hide or evade, but it could also encounter obstacles or hazards or lose sight of the target. A third factor was the enemy threat, which could affect the Comanche's vulnerability, survivability, and effectiveness. The Comanche could evade enemy radar and missiles and perform covert missions and surprise attacks. Still, it could also face cyberattacks, jamming, or counter-stealth technologies. The Comanche was a visionary and ambitious helicopter program that aimed to create a stealthy and versatile scout and light attack helicopter for the U.S. Army. But it was also a costly and controversial program that faced many problems and challenges. The Comanche's history and milestones were its inception, competition, prototypes, flight tests, and the engineering and manufacturing development phase. The Comanche program started in 1983, when the U.S. Army launched the Light Helicopter Experimental Program to replace its aging fleet of helicopters, such as the UH-1, AH-1, OH-6, and OH-58. In 1988, the Army selected two teams, Boeing-Sikorsky and Bell McDonnell Douglas, to develop their concepts. In 1991, the Army chose the Boeing-Sikorsky design as the winner, and awarded them a contract to build 6 prototypes. The Comanche was officially named RAH-66, and the prototype rolled out in 1995. The first flight took place in 1996, and the second prototype flew in 1999. The program entered the engineering and manufacturing development phase in 2000, with plans to produce 5 more prototypes and 650 operational helicopters. However, The Comanche program faced many challenges and delays due to budget cuts, requirement changes, technical problems, operational challenges, and strategic shifts. The Comanche's weight and cost increased over time, while its performance and survivability decreased. The Comanche also faced competition from other helicopter programs, such as the AH-64D Longbow Apache, the UH-60M Black Hawk, and the OH-58D Kiowa Warrior, which were upgraded and modernized. The Comanche also faced the emergence of unmanned aerial vehicles, such as the MQ-1 Predator and the RQ-7 Shadow, which could perform some of the same scouting and targeting roles as the Comanche but with less risk and cost. In 2004, the U.S. Army decided to cancel the Comanche program, after spending nearly $7 billion in producing only two prototypes. The Army said it needed to invest in upgrading its existing helicopters and developing new UAVs, rather than pursuing a new and expensive helicopter that would require many upgrades to be viable on the battlefield. The consequences and implications of the Comanche's cancellation were the termination fees, the loss of jobs, the impact on the helicopter industry, the redirection of funds to other programs. The cancellation of the Comanche program cost the Army and the contractors about $450 to $680 million in termination fees. It resulted in the loss of about 1,300 jobs at Boeing and Sikorsky. The cancellation also affected the helicopter industry, which had invested heavily in the Comanche program and expected to benefit from its production and export. The cancellation also freed up funds for the Army to upgrade and modernize its existing helicopters, such as the Apache, the Black Hawk, and the Kiowa, and to develop new UAVs, such as the MQ-8 Fire Scout and the MQ-1C Gray Eagle. The Comanche's legacy and alternatives were the Armed Reconnaissance Helicopter Program, the Future Vertical Lift Program, the Unmanned Aerial Vehicles. After canceling the Comanche, the Army launched the Armed Reconnaissance Helicopter Program to find a replacement for the Kiowa. The program selected the Bell ARH-70 Arapaho, a modified version of the Bell 407 civilian helicopter. Still, the program was also canceled in 2008 due to cost overruns and delays. The Army then decided to upgrade the Kiowa with new sensors and weapons, and to use the Apache and the UAVs for the reconnaissance role. The Army also initiated the Future Vertical Lift Program, which aims to develop a family of new helicopters with improved speed, range, payload, and survivability. The program has attracted several proposals, such as the Sikorsky Boeing SB-1 Defiant and the Bell V-280 Valor. The Army also increased its use of UAVs, which can perform some of the scouting and targeting functions of the Comanche, but with less risk and cost. The Army has deployed several types of UAVs, such as the RQ-7 Shadow, the MQ-1C Gray Eagle, and the RQ-11 Raven. The Comanche was a helicopter that could have been, but never was. It was a dream that never came true, but it was also a lesson that never should be forgotten. The Comanche showed the potential and the challenges of developing a stealthy and versatile helicopter for the U.S. Army. It also showed the importance and the difficulty of balancing the requirements, the costs, the risks, and the benefits of a complex and ambitious program. The Comanche's design, technology, and capabilities influenced other helicopter and UAV programs, and its cancellation prompted the Army to rethink its helicopter and aviation strategy. The Comanche was a helicopter that could have changed the world, but it also changed itself. That's it for this video. What do you think of the Comanche? Do you think it was a success or a failure? Do you think it could have been a game changer or a waste of money? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. The sky is not the limit, it's just the beginning. Thanks for watching, see you next time.